Namaste. My session is on human rights. Generally, rights are defined as claims of the individual, recognized by the society and enforced by the state. These are considered essential claims, as without these, and no one can in general seek to be one at least. Human rights, the term human rights is however much broader than the term rights insofar as it means. So human rights are rights independent of particular condition of social recognition, and these are inherent in the very nature of a human being as a conscious and self-respecting individual. These are the very basis of human life, dignity and worth. These are the natural and essential conditions of happy and the prosperous living of all the people of the world. Then there is a Universal Declaration of Human Rights on 10 December 1948. Acting under the provision of the UN Charter, the Human Rights Commission was established in February 1946 by the UN Economic and Social Council. This commission was directed to prepare recommendations and report, just like an international bill of human rights, international conventions or declaration on civil liberties, the status of women, freedom of information and similar other matters, the protection of minorities, the prevention of discrimination on the basis of race, sex, language or religion, and other concern and other matter concerning human rights. Then the commission labored for more than 30 months and prepared the text of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and some other conventions. Declaration of Human Rights was adopted by the UN General Assembly on 10 December 1948, and each year 10 December is celebrated as a Human Rights Day in the whole world. So, UN Declaration of Human Rights give recognition to the following rights of all humans. The UDHR, yani the United Nations Declaration, contains a comprehensive account of human rights to all the people of the world. Like faith in the human freedom, equality, dignity and rights, human rights without any distinction, right to life, like Article 3, then freedom from slavery and the servitude, then right against torture and inhuman and the degrading treatment, like Article 5th, then there is a right of recognition as a human person, like Article 6, then equality before law, then right to seek protection in Article 8, then prohibition of arbitrary arrest and the detention of exile, then right to get justice from an independent judiciary, right to get fair trial, then right to privacy of family, home and the correspondence, right to freedom of movement and residence with the border of each state, then right to asylum, then a right to nationality, then right to marriage and family life and dissolution of marriage in Article 16, like then right to property, Article 17, right to freedom of thought, conscience and religion, Article 18, right to freedom of speech and expression, 19, then right to freedom of peaceful assembly and association. Then there is within it, there are some political rights involved in it, just right to political participation, right to franchise, right to choose one representative, that is right to free use of right to vote, right to hold public office, equal opportunity and access to public service in the country, right to criticize the policies of the government, then right to social security and culture freedom, then right to work, free choice of employment, protection against unemployment, just and the favorable condition of work, then right to rest and leisure, reasonable working hours and periodic holidays, then right to a decent standard of living for a personal and his family, then there is a right to education, then right to participate in the cultural life of the community, then there is a right to have a social and international order conducive for the right and the freedoms enshrined in the UDHR, and then Article 29, there is a duties towards the community. So generally you can say that Article 1 and 2 of the UDHR are governing articles, and these lay down two cardinal facts. The first are all human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights, and the second one is everyone is entitled to all the rights and freedoms of the set forth in this declaration. So after this you can discuss about after this there is a from the UDH 1948 to two International Covenant on Human Rights. And in order to make the rights described in the UDHR binding, the Commission on Human Rights initiated the process of drafting a binding treaty among the state. It could do so in about 18 years after the adoption of the UDHR. Two international covenants were prepared and these were adopted by the UN General Assembly in 1966. The first is called the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, which we call as ICCPR, and the International Covenant on Economic, Social and Political Rights, that is ICESCR. Two optional protocols were also made, one in 1966 and another in 1989. The International Covenant came into force on 1976. The UDHR and the ICCPR and the ICACCR and the two optional protocols together constitute the major part of the International Bill of Human Rights. Now, we'll discuss about the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. The International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, 1966, contains 53 articles which stand divided into six parts. And the ICCPR contain the following rights, like the first right to self-determination, right to life, right to liberty and security, freedom from torture or to cruel, inhuman or degrading treatment or punishment, freedom from slavery and the servitude, right to liberty of movement, right to fair trial, right to freedom of thought, conscience and religion, right to recognition as a person before the law, right to peaceful assembly and etc. The rights contained in this covenant are known as a first generation rights, and these provide certain basic guarantees for the individual in relation to the state. These are rights against any invasive action on part of the state. These can also be described as a negative rights, as these provides for no state interference in these rights and freedoms. Then after this, there is an International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, that is ICESCR 1966. The International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights was adopted and the throne opened for the signature by the UN General Assembly on 16 December 1966. It came into force on 3rd January 1976. ICESCR also opens with the preamble and contains 31 articles divided into 5. Like part 1, which refer the right of self-determination of all the people and calls upon states to respect the right. There is a part 2, then there is a part 3, which lay down the social, economic and cultural rights of all people. Then there is a part 4, which calls upon the state to send reports on the implementation of these rights on the UN. And there is a part 5, which makes a covenant open for the signature. So right include in the International Covenant on Economic, Social and Political Rights are the right to self-determination, right to work, right to enjoy just and favorable condition of work, right to form trade unions, right to social security, right to adequate standard of living including adequate food, clothing and housing, right to enjoyment of highest attainable standard of physical and mental health, right to participate in cultural life, right to enjoy the benefits of scientific progress and its applications. These rights constitute the second generation rights. These require affirmative or positive action on the part of the state for providing certain basic economic, social and cultural needs and amenities of the people. That is why these are characterized as a positive rights. ICCR requires positive action on the part of each state in respect of its obligation towards the promotion of economic, social and cultural rights of state. However, Article 2 of the ICESCR accepts that these rights can be attained only progressively. It accepts that their implementation can be subject to the availability of resources with the states, particularly the developing states of the this. So, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, in order to give also, so while adopting this Universal Declaration of Human Rights, it was clear stated that there is no way this declaration interfere with the domestic jurisdiction of each. However, basically, the declaration has a moral and legal authority. It represents the common wish and the common concern of the humankind for future and good behavior. So, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and the treaties, conventions, covenant made since 1948 have influenced all the states to work for the securing and protection of human rights in their territories.